The following is a BATV production, made with the equipment that is available to residents of our cable viewing area. To learn more about television production and the equipment that is available to you, please visit www.mybatv.com.
I'm your host, Noah Gabriel. Thank you for being here. We've got a very special guest tonight. Actually, well, every month we have special guests. They're all special, that's why they're here. But tonight we have Jim Green, formerly known as the Wandering Endorphin. I don't know if you've seen him before. I'm guessing a lot of you have, but he's pretty incredible to watch. Just on a little personal thing, Jim actually gave me my first show. Way back in the day, I was a Starbucks employee, and he ran an open mic there and invited me to come and play a show with him out in Naperville, and it kind of got the ball rolling for me. So it's always nice to get to play with him and watch him, and here he is, Jim Green.
Thank you. Please be seated. Thank you. First, what I'm going to do is called Wanderlust. Remember this one, Greg? Greg helped me out with this in the recording. He played bass. But yeah, this is Wanderlust. Thank you. So I remember when Kiss the Sky was at the old location in Batavia, on Randall Road. That's where I first discovered the store. And I've... I became a fan of Kiss the Sky when I walked in just after my divorce. And I was looking for some music to, I don't know, just make me feel better somehow. And the first CD I saw, which was a used CD, was a Johnny Cash CD. And I put it in the player, and it was Delia's Gone. It was a murdered love ballad. And it was about, I was like, yeah, yeah, that's good. That's making me feel better. And I didn't need it. I sat there and listened to that whole CD all the way through. And just looked around and was like, this is a great place. So it's nice that they're invited again.
Some way I feel, send the joker to flee. It's too much confusion here, I can't get no relief. Businessman and drink my wine, commented my earth. None of them Fifi calmly spoke. There's many here among us feel that life is a joke. But you and I were paying for that. This is not our fate. So let us not talk fast now.
You'll notice a common theme up here, and that's me tuning the guitar. Every song is a new tuning. Don't ever mistake it for the intro. Unless you like it. If you like it, tell me. I'll remember the tuning. Thanks to Noah for asking me to be here, and I guess Steve to approve it. No. Just kidding. But I remember when, as Noah was talking about earlier, about him working at Starbucks, and I'm not sure if it was the first open mic that I did at that Starbucks or it was some other night, but anyway, I remember him and me, the host, were the only ones to show up. And Noah, you know, I was like, well, Noah, you can play as long as you want, as much as you want. And he got up there and he started singing. I was like, holy crap. that guy really needs some vocal lessons. Just kidding. No, he's amazing, which you will hear in the next set. We're going to do a song together. In fact, I have a few artists coming up in the next set. I got Rob Anderlich from the Old Town School of Folk Music playing dobro, John Michaels, also from Chicago, and I didn't forget you, Barb. Lovely Barb up front here. Do one more instrumental here. I'm gonna do more than one. I'm gonna do an instrumental that's called Making Tracks. It's about hiking. This is a song that the lyrics are from a poem. The music is mine, but the lyrics from a poem that I was reading in bed one time. The author is Lawrence Dunbar. He's kind of recognized as the first African American poet. Late 1800s, I think is when he started. Anyway, I was reading this poem and I was like, wow, this sounds like a blues song if I've ever heard one. So I went to my guitar and thought, well, what's this gonna sound like, you know, reading it. And I remember, I think it was John Lee Hooker or somebody who said, you only need to know 2 good chords to make a good song, a great song, you know. This one's got 4. It's called Jump Back, Honey. Thank you.
you squeezed her tight. Seen a light gleam in her eye. Caught a little smile gone floating by. Jump back, honey, jump back. Jump back, honey, jump back. Heard the wind blow through the pine. Mockingbird was singing fine. And my heart was beating so. When I reached my lady, couldn't better let go. Jump back, honey, jump back. Jump back, honey, jump back. Hey. Put my arms around her waist. Raised her lips and took a taste. Do you love me like I love you? And she answered, of course I do. Jump back, honey, jump back. Jump back, honey, jump back. Jump back, honey, jump back. Jump back, honey, jump back.
I don't think there's anyone in here who probably doesn't know who Greg Brenner is. He's sitting right over there, slouching in a chair like a lazy bum. He's a fantastic singer-songwriter here in town, and a great blues man, Fox Belly blues man. Did I hear someone say wow? Wow. All right, that's a good title. Well, in making my latest CD, which is actually not that recent, I'm sorry to say, it's from 2009, I'm about due. I definitely have enough material. But in kind of writing it and recording it, I was trying to get inspiration because I made it kind of like a train theme CD. Lots of train songs. And I found this book at the library that was written by ex-King of the Hobos. And it was a book on how to jump a train. That was the whole book, how to jump a train. It was like this thick. And in there I learned some hobo lingo. I don't remember much of it anymore because I haven't put it to use, thank God. But there was a word that kind of just stuck with me. And one of the words was hotshot. And he said, that's a train that's got time-sensitive freight, and it's going to take off. It's going to take off fast, and it's not going to stop until it gets there. And he kind of warned you, if you get on a hotshot, you better hang on because you're really in for a ride. This is called hotshot. Thank you.
myself. I'm talking to the sound guy, who also happens to be named Jim. That's your job. That's your job.
Okay. There's something I remembered that Michael Hedges, he's Michael Hedges, if you don't know who Michael Hedges is, he's a guitar player. He was incredible. And he's my number one influence for playing acoustic guitar. In an interview, he was talking about listening and remembering, it just about being on stage, and he would have to remind himself that he's playing, well,
you know, as he's playing, I'm playing for these people. Sometimes you forget because you get lost in the song. And he talked about how you can, there's three things you can think of while you're playing. You can think of what you just played. You can play what you're playing at that present moment. And you can think about what you're gonna play as you're playing. Actually, he was wrong because while I was just playing that last piece, I was thinking about what I was gonna have for dinner tonight. And that's where I messed up. I don't know if you all caught it or not, but yeah, I was thinking of some nice hummus with some vegetables. Oh, okay. And I was like, oh yeah, I'm playing for people. Here we are. I'm gonna play a song that I wrote while I was in Israel, and this is a tune I wrote on the cliff overlooking the Mediterranean Sea by a harbor, and saw the sailboat just kind of go out to sea, and was right in line with the setting sun. And it was just a beautiful moment. This song just kind of came right out, and I've since where's my capo? Once it was written, I was street performing there, and I remember I'd take my guitar and amp and head down there. I'd be on the beach street performing, and there was one time, again, the sun was setting. People were walking along the boardwalk enjoying the sunset. And as I was playing this song, a couple started dancing near me. And I was like, oh, that's beautiful. And then another couple started dancing, and another couple started dancing, and another couple started dancing. And I was like, boy, I better not screw this up. It's a lot of pressure with all these people dancing around me. Called Sailing Sunsets. Thank you.
just a couple more for you guys. I'm going to take a break. Get some other folks up here. Does everybody have their cell phone off? I say that because I don't want you to be embarrassed if it goes off. It's not for me. A few gigs ago, I said that, and as I was playing, my phone was going off. I was like, what? Unbelievable. I just mentioned it, you know, and turned out it was mine. So I answered it. And it was my brother, and I said, well, John, I'm a little busy right now on the microphone with the phone. I was like, can I put you on speaker, you know? So we had a very short conversation. It was very entertaining for everyone. So this percussive style I've been doing since 1999, way back in the 1900s. And this is this next song I'm going to play is one of the earlier ones. It's so nice I recorded it twice. It's called Firefly. Did you catch my move? I call it my Greg Burner move when I, where was it? You need to do it by the microphone so everyone can hear it, right? Like, check it out. I love it. I see him do that. I was like, I gotta use that somewhere. All right, one more tune here. I was taking some blues harmonica classes at the Old Town School of Folk Music, and a teacher brought in this tape of cassette tape of harmonica players doing train songs, you know, with all the chugging or kind of stuff. And
loved it.
And these guys were brilliant at it. These the songs themselves were very detailed in their titles. You know, it was like a train going over a bridge and the guy's chugging along and he's doing stuff to this harmonica. It's making it sound like it's going over a bridge now. And there's one where it said train hits dog and it's like wow and just like a yelp out there and train kept going. And I thought it was a cool idea to try and translate that to guitar. Not that that's not been done before, but in this percussive style. So this is what I came up with. This is called Boxcar Man. And I think we'll take a break after this this song and let you guys talk and use the facilities. And we'll be back. So this is Boxcar Man. This is my whistle.
Whistle singing high, that's gotta be my Northern Union line. I gotta get gone again. Grab my bindle, running through the brush. Switch me, yell down, what the hell's a rush? With a ticket to nowhere, I live on the rail. I'm a boxcar man on the iron trail. I live on the rail. Gotta get going when that whistle wails. Came from Memphis looking for some work. Club by the Apple, deck of Kaiserbuck. I'm traveling hard these days. I live on the rail. I'm a boxcar man on the iron trail. I live on the rail. Gotta get going, that whistle wails. Boxcar man on the iron trail. I live on the rail. Gotta get going, that whistle wails. That bridge. I hate those crossings. It's a mountain.
Take one. All right, here we go. Thank you. Thanks for the applause. We'll be back in about 10 minutes. Thank you.
All right, everybody. We're going to get the show going again. Thanks for being here. Thanks for sticking around. Jim is sounding great tonight. So we will begin the second half of Live from Kiss the Sky.
That's your cue to applaud.
Thank you.
Like I mentioned before, I use a lot of different tunings, and this tuning I'm in right now, I actually have several songs written in, which is nice for you know, playing in front of folks and not having to have you wait for me to... And the only thing is, most of them are slow songs, so I can't play them again and again next to each other. But in writing this next piece, I noticed how all the songs in this tuning have kind of a cosmic name to them, like stargazing, and when the moon was full of mystery, so on. So I didn't want to break tradition, so I named it in line with those other ones, and I still was able to relate it to the guitar. So I thought I was very clever in naming it String Theory.
How's it going, Chuck?
Am I making enough, I see you got, I hear you're clicking away and everything. Am I making enough guitar faces for you to make it worth the trouble? Just, I can fake them if you needed anything. Just let me know. You know, jump up and down. No, Jim, you make a fool of yourself just enough to make it worth it. Do this song, and then I'm gonna bring up Rob after this tune. This is called the Endorphin Jig. Noah, earlier, Noah spoke of us meeting at an open mic, and I actually met Rob at an open mic. So, open mics can be pretty cool. And what was it, Arlington Heights, I think, Rob? I think the first song we'll do is one that's on my EP.
Sorry about that.
That happens. Yeah. There's a lot of stuff up there. Half of it is ours. Well, this song is called Rebound Man, and it's basically it's a dark love song, but it's not about love. It's, I'm just trying to kill time thinking about the song. Yeah, okay. It's about little bunnies. that once upon a time. No, it's like how people can say love is a game. Well, dating at times can be a game too. And coming up with the lyrics for this song, I try to relate a lot of the lyrics to games. Like, for the title, for one, Rebound Man. Do you know which one I'm talking about?
Says he loves you, but it ain't true. He said what he needed to say to get inside of you. Rumors are flying, and you feel used. You found out you want true love has already got to. You took a shot on him, now he's out. I could step right in with the stroke of a hand. You can let me know I'm your rebound man. Took a shot on him, now he's out. I could step right in. Would it be all wrong to run this plan while you're not so strong? Let us blur the lines, keep on kissing that glass of wine. With a stroke of a hand, she lets me know I'm a rebound man.
Very good, sir.
Got off to a great start.
This has been Rob has been kind enough to play on my records. In fact, if you like that last song, it's on the EP, and I don't have it with me, but you can download it at the website. Okay, ready? Right.
was minding my business, holding the fort. And I still remember how you said the fourth in my mind, it was busy, wanting my heart. Hell, you ain't a cowboy unless you've been bucked off. Well, the story's familiar, the oldest tale in the West. I fell to love, and the bird left the nest. Well, I guess there are reasons, let our hard hearts go soft. You ain't a cowboy, unless you've been bucked off. Well, there's all kinds of voices lead you grabbing the breeze. Busted up and broken up, the scars you can't see. But if you haven't been bucked off and thrown a few times, it won't count for nothing when you make that last ride. Many years have passed, ain't nothing the same. Only I don't feel different, you find the change. Well, I guess what I'm saying, give it just one last night. Cause you ain't a cowboy unless you've been bucked off. You ain't a cowboy unless you've been bucked
off. We're going to do a John Hiatt song. Big fan of John Hiatt's songwriting. This is not how he does the song, but so we kind of countryfied it. But nevertheless, I hope you enjoy it. Here we go.
Something broken in my heart, oh, it was nothing you'd done. Something broken in my heart, maybe that's just the way you come. Something broken in my heart, something I just can't fix. Something broken in my heart. Tried every powder and every pill to put it back together somehow. But how with the food up on the hill, and down with the dreadful scent of flour. Now to the land of milk and honey, and honey I'm broke down now. There's something broken in my heart. I'm gonna go down town tonight and find me a woman and try to keep those jagged edges from my mind. And if I don't start a fight, I'll just keep running. till I break on through to the morning light. Something broken in my heart. Oh, it was nothing you'd done. Something broken in my heart. Maybe I'm not the only one. Something broken in my heart. Something I just can't fix. There's something broken in my heart. There's something broken in my heart, in my heart.
Awesome, isn't he?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. That's your next guy right there. Rob is going to, I'm going to let him really show off here for you guys. He's going to do one on his own. So everybody give it up for Rob Anderlich.
Before I do a song, I just have a question for the record guys. What section would you put Jim's music in? That's what I'd like to know. Flamenco, the Michael Hedges section. And the other question I have is, how do you wake up in the morning and do that without hurting yourself? That's the other thing that I'd like to know.
We're breaking it down.
I'm going to do a song for you. I should play something like, you know, really fast and whatever. But I'm going to do this kind of pretty number called Grant's Corner for you. Thank you. Thank you.
John, Barb, come on up. Rob's got, if anyone's interested in playing Dobo, you still have lessons on your website, right? And which is robenterlich.com. You probably have cards if anybody wants to see him about that. And also, he actually teaches at the Old Town School of Folk Music. And this next guy I'm going to bring up, he is not only a good friend, but a great songwriter. I was really privileged to work with John on his latest project, and he actually has the vinyls here. I highly encourage you to buy them, just for the fact that I'm telling you to. I know you ain't gonna hear them, but it's a great, great album. I'm prouder of that than anything I've ever recorded, and I basically saved the album from utter destruction. It wasn't good until I came out. No. So me and the bass player like to say, we saved the album, John. We saved the album. But
why don't you want to introduce yourself?
Sure. This is John Michaels, and this is Barbara Hall here.
Well, I wasn't expecting that. Thanks, Jim. It's always an honor to share a stage with Jim. He's been one of my favorite musicians ever since the first time I saw him. Watching what he did, and we instantly became kind of friends after that. Had the pleasure of doing a little tour with him not too long ago. I did meet him at an open mic though, but I did meet Barbara at an open mic, and I just met Rob tonight here on the stage earlier.
Hello. I'll meet you later.
This is a song that Jim and I actually collaborated on. We've been doing things for years and playing together and never collaborated, and I heard some of his instrumentals and found myself kind of humming along at times, and I asked him, I said, how would you feel about me taking a crack at writing some lyrics? And this one was the first one that kind of really hit me, and special thanks to Robert Frost for giving me the line I needed to finish it. But also I want to mention Barb here. She is a fantastic singer. She may be standing in the background, but trust me, when she's on her own with the guitar, she's a combination of Janis Joplin and Bonnie Raitt.
If you
want to see the three of us like kind of exchanging songs, we're going to be doing a little show that Jim put together on Common Ground in Chicago. This is called Southbound.
And miles to go before you sleep. see this dream that's hanging on to me. There's miles to go before you
Hello?
There we are. Okay. I do the title track to Bar, This Is Not the Time, to fiddle with that during a slow song. I'm just kidding, go ahead. We'll just wait. We'll all wait for you. I'm just messing with you. So this is the title track to one of my CDs called When the Moon Was Full of Mystery. As you can tell by the title, it's kind of a slow, not in tune. What's wrong there? It's in B flat. I just happen to have that second string in B. There we go. Okay. Yeah. So it's got this lovely slow progression. And with the title, When the Moon Is Full of Mystery, you know, it's imagine all kinds of nice things. I was very happy with the song, so I wanted to make a video of it, and I didn't want people to act out what was happening in the song and make it kind of cheesy. So I found this girl who was doing computer animation on YouTube, and she was doing it really well. I was really impressed with some of the stuff she came up with. I asked her if she wanted to make the video. She said, sure. And she asked me, well, what do you want to see in there? I was like, well, obviously a full moon would be good. And you know, it's about two lovers that were torn away when they were younger and met each other again much later in life, in their 60s, and kind of picked off again right where they left off. And so it'd be great to, as the song starts out, you know, they're taking this walk down memory lane, so to speak, through the forest to the tree where they used to meet in secret. So it'd be great to see that and maybe some fireflies. And I said, the rest is up to you. You're an artist, you know. You have artistic freedom to do whatever you want. I know it's going to be amazing. So 2 months went by, and she sent me the video finally. And I started it, and it looked great. And there, she's got these fireflies in there, which I loved. And I saw the full moon, they're walking through the forest, and all the things I asked for. So that was about like the first 40 seconds of the video. And then suddenly the couple was in the city walking, and they got mugged. And because of the mugging, the girl ended up in a coma. And when she got out of the coma, she looked great, by the way. She looked great even after 40 years in a coma. And she went to see the guy she was in love with, and he remarried. And so she left very sad. And just this whole soap opera thing going on. And they met at the end in the cemetery. And was like, hey, you're visiting your parents that are dead now? I'm visiting my wife that's now dead. I'm available. And they picked it up, and they were in love again. And I was like, God. I told her artistic freedom. Oh, well, it's my fault. But hopefully you won't picture muggings and comas when you hear this. Through the woods, we still got some get up and go. That might surprise some folks since we're 60 years old. But we're shuffling our feet, cause we're gonna meet under our tree, just you and me. Remembering when the moon was full of mystery, I remember we'd run this trail, arms stretched out from our sides. We'd pretend to fly away somewhere where the world no one buys. Back then the world was stranger, our dreams were bigger, your doubts tougher, the trees seemed taller, and the moon was full of mystery. So let's hold each other now under our tree. Yeah, remember when my eyes were brighter, your hair was fairer, we were greener, and I was your lover when the moon, yeah, said the moon, when the moon was so, so full of mystery. Thank you. Bob Enderlich, everyone. Fantastic. I love this guy. My next special guest is someone you all know by the name of Noah Gabriel. Come here, Noah. Come to me. Jim, this is the one with the flute, so I'm gonna need the reverb on that back mic there.
Hi, everybody. One day I'm gonna get Jim to record this song with me doing this. This is the title track off my second album called Truth, Love, Faith, and Soul. Thank you.
stand upon the shores and let it wash me away.
A full band version of the song. I love playing it with somebody on lead, especially someone so talented like Noah here. And Greg, you've played lead on this. This is Let It Ride. Greg does a great job in here too.
just, oh, you can, oh, you. Oh, the enemy.
Thanks for being here, folks. Really appreciate it. Thanks for coming. This kind of things you never know, you know, because I play restaurants and bars, and you kind of expect people to be there, and they are, and people come to see you, great. But this kind of venue, it relies on people actually coming here to listen to music, and I thank you for doing that, because this wouldn't be a lot of fun. This would just be like practice in the bedroom for me. Stand back there. You hiding? Oh, you want to be with a cool guy. All right. Like sit in the back of the classroom kind of thing, the back of the bus. All right. You guys belong there. You guys are the cool guys. You do look good. I just want people to see you. I got some shows coming up at a house pub in St. Charles, and before I forget, I really want to thank Steve and Kiss This Guy for having all this and supporting local music. They have a new compilation coming out too of local music. He was playing it when I came in, and I'm pretty impressed by it actually. So ask him about that.
Don't say the title, bro.
Don't say the title. No, you can't say the title.
It's good stuff.
So here we go. This is another John Hyatt song. It's called Tiki Bar. And if you want any CDs, come see me. If you want any these guys' CDs, see them. It's a lot of C's. So here we go.
God, the tiki bar is open. Thank God, the tiki torch still shines. Thank God, the tiki bar is open. Come on in and open up your mind. Well, I was out on the leave of absence from every semblance reality. But like a rocket launch from the great blue yawn, the phone, the boys, and a Kennedy. Well, I was driving by Majesty's cold hotel where the sign said to praise his name. Well, I was tied in a load, I couldn't see too well, but I don't think that he was to blame. So thank God the tiki bar is open. Thank God the tiki torch still shines. Thank God the tiki bar is open. Come on in and open up your mind. Take it right. There's a full moon over Daytona Beach. There's a full moon in my mind. Well, I'm a suntan dream, but still out of reach. And the strip malls are robbing me blind. Well, his name was Mr. Dale Earnhardt, and he drove a black number 3. Now the king is gone, but not forgotten. No, his life will we ever see. So thank God the tiki open. Thank God the tiki torch still shines. Thank God the tiki bar is open. Come on in and open up your mind. Tell them about Noah. Thank you. Well, I know a drink ain't a solution. Ain't had one in 17 years. But if that tiki bar was closed tonight, well, I might just disappear. So thank God the tiki bar is open. Thank God the tiki torch still shines. Thank God the tiki bar is open. Come on in, open up your mind.
Take over, Noah. Come on. Still shines. Thank God the tiki bar is open. Come on in and open up your mind.
Woo! Thank you, Barb. Thank you, John. You guys have a good night. Thanks for being here. Hope to see you again. Thank you.
Keep it going for Jim, everybody. Thank you for coming down. Thank you, Steve, and Kiss the Sky for hosting this, D for helping set this all up. Jim, of course, back there behind the soundboard, bringing the music to your ears. And of course, BATV for helping us keep this program going and putting it on the air. I'm Noah Gabriel. Come back next month. The Leadfoot Band will be here. If you're a fan of bluegrass, you're not gonna wanna miss it. They are pretty darn incredible. Come on down.